The civil society organizations have commended government to introduce the parish development model. They say it will benefit those that have been cut off by the technocrats and corrupt officials. They were speaking at a media briefing today in Kampala, where they also gave their recommendations. Take a look.
While presenting the budget for the financial year 2021-2022, the Minister of Finance, in his budget speech, presented the parish development model as an approach to organizing and delivering public and private sector interventions for wealth creation, including investment planning, budgeting and service delivery at the parish level as the lowest planning unit. The model, in the financial year starting July 2021, shall be rolled out to 10,594 parishes in the country to create income-generating opportunities. Now, civil society organizations say this is a welcome move by government as it's directly targeting to eradicate Ugandans from poverty and also ensure service delivery reaching the final man. The parish development model is the last mile strategy by government of Uganda for improving incomes and welfare of all Ugandans at the household level. Agnes Jirabo, the executive director for Food Rights Alliance, says government should ensure that the program eradicates poverty totally across the country.
The parish development model, now that it is going at the parish level, we need a more clarified mechanism of how insurance service delivery by the system that is existing now, the agriculture insurance scheme, is quickly moving to work with the parish model. And then these farmers and MSMEs that are operating at the lower levels of the value chain have access to this shield and then be able to invest.
This, she believes, must be done through empowering every citizen at the different parishes across the country. Jen Nalunga, the country director for Siatin Uganda, says the model should focus on three commodities of coffee, milk and fish that has proven to be having a comparative advantage both at the local and international markets. However, her recommendation is that the focus is put on value addition to ensure that the exports create more income for Ugandans.
At household level, and also to ensure socio-economic transformation. But I think I need to add on also increasing incomes at national level, because at the national level, government is also impoverished. It's indebted to a tune of 65 or 68 trillion. So we need to look at this parish model addressing such challenges.
Those in the extension services also say government should only employ those that are experienced to ensure that. An expert from Uganda Forum for Agriculture Services saying extension service workers should be qualified to ensure that the program benefits the locals.
A strategy for youth employment in agriculture. And I think this is the right time now for government to come full scale to put this strategy into implementation through the parish development model, where the biggest number of players who we should be targeting are the young people who make over 70% of our population. These young people have the energies, as you may know.
This, they believe, will eliminate the middlemen that have been frustrating government projects.